One of the most common ways autism is described today is as a developmental disorder. That is a disorder that disturbs the development of social and communication skills and deeply affects one's behavior. We see that autistic behaviors emerge at a very early age and in a way are never brought to an end, even in adulthood. In its most severe cases, autistic people come to completely shut themselves off from the external world, lose all interest in other people, and adopt repetitive routines like shaking or repeating a specific word or sound. But in many other cases, autistic people live a relatively normal life, mostly having trouble communicating with others and finding their place in society. One can say that autism was discovered in the late 1940s by two contemporary psychiatrists, Leo Kanner and Hans Asperger. Until the time of these two pioneering thinkers, autistic people were described as being psychotic. Kanner and Asperger were the first ones to extract autism from the domain of psychosis and designate it as a distinct psychological syndrome.
The syndrome of early infantile autism is by now reasonably well established and commonly accepted as a psychopathologic pattern. The symptom combination, in most instances, warrants an unequivocal diagnostic formulation.
While working with autistic patients, Kanner and Asperger carefully noted their unique behaviors. And already at that time, when autism only emerged into the scientific field of vision, these two have already noticed how autistic people have problems using language, how they disregard other people, and have an extreme sensory sensitivity. These unique autistic traits were arranged under two major categories that Kanner called sameness and aloneness. The first, having to do with the desire to keep the world static and unchangeable. The second, having to do with the desire to stay alone and away from the gaze of others.
The child's behavior is governed by an anxiously obsessive desire for the maintenance of sameness that nobody but the child himself may disrupt on rare occasions. There is, from the start, an extreme autistic aloneness that, whenever possible, disregards, ignores, shuts out anything that comes to the child from the outside.
It's quite interesting and important to say that these two categories can still be found today in a revised or altered form in some of the most important diagnostic manuals for psychiatrists. The most popular diagnostic manual today that also has a section on autism is the American Psychiatric Association's Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, also shortly known as DSM-5. The DSM-5 attempts to offer a standardized method for the diagnosis of autism. And this basically means a method that is based on statistical studies. In a section on developmental disorders, the DSM-5 has an entry called Autism Spectrum Disorder. The Autism Spectrum Disorder can be viewed as a long line on which many unique autistic traits that have to do with communication and social interaction are distributed. It is demarcated by two poles of functionality, a low and a high pole. Now, according to the DSM-5, the severity of autism is determined by how many of these autistic traits a person exhibits. The more autistic traits we see, and the stronger and more frequent they are, the more severe a diagnosis of autism will be, varying on a spectrum between high-functioning autism and the more severe low-functioning autism.